Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to create a final year project report absolutely for free by using ChatGPT. So let's get started. First thing, we need to get the report template, and this can vary from country to country or university to university. So first, just come to the home interface of ChatGPT, and here we'll be having tools, right? Click it and make sure that we are giving think for longer, because that is a better model when compared to the normal 4.0 model. So this is going to be my prompt. Can you create me a college project report template? I want a single response so it is easy to copy. In case if you have any specification, like if it is a mechanical project or related to arts or computer science, you can also specify that over here. In my case, I'm just going with a normal one and I will just send it. So it has given the response. As you can see, title page, declaration, certificate, acknowledgement, abstract, table of contents, chapter 1 introduction, a literature review, and so much of other stuff. So basically we can just copy this. I asked it to give it in a single response, but it has given it in multiple parts, but it's fine. We can simply do Control A. This will basically copy everything, and Control C to copy it. Now just open Notepad and paste this. We can just like remove this stuff. Yeah, this isn't required. And if you go up to the top, we also had this stuff. Okay, we can just remove this. Yep, so we have got our template ready. Now we'll be using ChatGPT's deep research feature to create us our report. So just copy this and go to ChatGPT, new chat, and here again go to tools, and you will be having the deep research feature. So this feature is available in the free version also. You can use this feature 5 times per month. Basically what this feature will does is, if you give a particular prompt, this will browse lots of websites across the web and extract data from it and create us a report. And that's the reason I have chosen this. So now come here and paste your template. And now the only thing that we are missing is our own title of our project. So we can't just simply add it and ask it to generate. So we also need to give some personal information over here. So for it, you can simply like add this one after the template, put a comma and paste this. So you can just pause the video and type it out. I've just given create each topic in a new page separately, and my project title is live hand gesture control using OpenCV. So this is a computer science based project, and here you can specify whatever the project title you have. And I've also given refer as many research papers and websites you can. Also add as much as images possible, and just have the text placeholder wherever you want any personal info, because here we are having lot of information about us, right? Let's say for example here the place, date. So that's the reason why I went on with the text placeholder. So in case if you're going to like copy paste from this particular report, you can simply search for placeholder globally and replace with your own data. And this is what I am giving as the prompt. In case if you want to customize it, you can do that. So now let me just send it. I'm sending this one with the template. Now ChatGPT will ask us some follow-up questions, and this could vary from user to user. In my case, it has asked what degree program or level are you pursuing, what kind of application does your project target. So I'll just answer each one. So I will go with BTech in computer science for the first one, and next one, what kind of application does your project target? Let me just go with IoT. So you can answer like this, just have answers and the question number, and just give your answer in comma separated form and just send it. So this will now begin creating our report. As you can see, the research has started. This will take like 5 to 10 minutes, because this will go through a lot of websites, lot of sources, research papers, and then extract data from it and condense it into the topic or the template that we have asked. So just be patient for a while. So after a while, as you can see, it has 11 sources. So if I just click it here, we have 2 tabs. One is activity and sources. In the activity, we can literally see what ChatGPT is performing at the moment. As it says, I am organizing a technical report on our topic, including this stuff, searched for live hand gesture control, and it says, let me compile these things. So we are getting step-by-step updates on the progress of ChatGPT. And next is the sources. If you click it, this will display the websites from where it has scrapped the data. So if you click it, it will directly take to the website where it is extracting the data. So that's also a good thing. So now let's just be patient till it gets completed. So the search has been completed and it took 10 minutes to do this from 42 sources and 61 searches. So these are the sources that it took. If you want to like check it out, you can just click on the link and read it through. And here we are having our final report. So we can just click this. It will open it in a much more bigger view. So we are having the title, and as I told you earlier, I asked you to put placeholder in the places of personal information. It has done that. We are having the certificate, acknowledgement, abstract, table of contents, chapter introduction, problem statement, objectives, scope, so much of stuff. So let's just download it as a PDF and view it better. So to the top, you can even like share this link to someone, or else you can just download it. This gets downloaded as a PDF by default, and we can just open it. So this is it. Basically, you can just scroll down and see it has also like indexed the site, also the citations. We are having the source of that particular context, and it has also given us the sample code and stuff, a table. So you can simply like screenshot this and use it in your report in case you are going to edit it. And it has also give the appendix or the sources from it has extracted the data. And of course, each university or college will have its own rules for margins, the topics and other stuff. You can just specify them, and in most of the cases you can reuse this particular stuff. You can simply copy this and use it in your documentation also, and really reduces our work to a greater extent. So that's the video, guys. I hope you'd have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.